She was sat at the seat.
There's no communion, is there?
No.
Oh, sorry.
Shut up. this book. Please say hello in the comments if you're watching. Beverly is on annual leave, so I'll be leaving the service this morning. My name is Beryl Vautier, and I'm the treasurer and almoner of St John's Parish Church. Before we start the service, I'd like to say a big thank you to Barnaby at the back for setting everything up and doing the technical stuff. Thanks to him, we've got everything on the screen and you're able to watch on live streaming. So thank you, Barnaby. We'll start the service. We've come from scattered lives to meet with God.
Let us recognize God's presence with us now.
As God's people, we have gathered. Let us worship God now together, across the miles, yet joined. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
In the light of Jesus, let us examine ourselves and confess our sins. Take a moment to allow the Holy Spirit to bring to mind anything from the past week where you want to say sorry to God. We say together,
Father, we have sinned against heaven and against you. We are not worthy to be called your children. Return to you again. Have mercy on us. Bring us back to yourself as those who once were dead, but now have life through Christ our Lord. Amen.
We say the confession. Where it says you, make save us, and where it says you'll save now, we say together.
May the Father forgive us by the death of his Son, and strengthen us to live in the power of the Spirit all our days. Amen.
Now we have our first hymn. We're still not able to sing, unfortunately, but you can come if you wish. Our first hymn is Thine Be Glory. Please stand.
Thank you.
verses 5 to 15. Moses writes this about the righteousness that is by the law. The person who does these things will live by them. But the righteousness that is the faith says, do not say in your heart, who will ascend into heaven? That is, to bring Christ down. Or, who will descend into the deep? That is, to bring Christ up from the dead. But what does it say? The word is near you. It is in your mouth and in your heart. That is the message concerning faith that we proclaim. If you declare with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified. And it is with your mouth that you profess your faith and are saved. As Scripture says, anyone who believes in him will never be put to shame, for there is no difference between Jew and Gentile. The same Lord is Lord of all, and richly blesses all who call on him. For anyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. How then can they call on the one they have not believed in? And how can they believe in the one of whom they have not heard? And how can they hear without someone preaching to them? And how can anyone preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring the good news. This is the word of the Lord.
And thanks be to God. Sin of the world, have mercy on us.
You are
There are two important messages in this morning's gospel reading, Jesus walking on water, and also Peter walking on water. It shows us who Jesus really is, and why we must keep our eyes firmly fixed on him. The disciples had witnessed Jesus performing many, many other miracles, with healing the sick and the lame, and earlier in Matthew, when he was asleep in a boat, the disciples woke him because they feared they were going to drown as the storm was raging all around them. Jesus stilled the wind and the waves. The disciples were amazed and they asked, "What kind of man is this? Even the winds and the waves obey him." Then, in this morning's reading, the boat was being buffeted by the waves because the wind was against it. But when Jesus climbed into the boat after walking on the water, the wind died down. Then, for the first time, the disciples realized and truly believed who Jesus was, and they worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." So then we find ourselves looking at what leads Peter to be walking on the water too. Prior to this reading, Jesus had been told that John the Baptist had been beheaded on the orders of King Herod, and Jesus withdrew to a solitary place to mourn the death of his cousin. But a large crowd of 5,000 men, plus women and children, had gathered, and although Jesus needed time to be alone, he had compassion on them, and after healing their sick, he fed them with 5 loaves and 2 fishes, another miracle. Jesus would then be emotionally and physically exhausted, so he made his disciples get into the boat and go to the other side of the lake, so that he could go up on the mountainside by himself to pray. During the fourth watch of the night, which is between 3 a.m. and 6 a.m, the boat would have been a long way from the shore in the middle of the lake, and was buffeted by the waves with the wind against it. Many of the disciples had been fishermen and were used to these conditions, so they weren't afraid at this point. But what made them terrified? They thought they saw a ghost walking on the lake. When they left Jesus on the shore, he would have been looking completely drained and exhausted, but after spending time in prayer with his Father, he would have been revitalized and refreshed and looked totally different. Because Jesus looked so different from when they left him on the shore, they did not recognize him until Jesus told them it was him and not to be afraid. Then Peter, always the impulsive one, says, "Lord, if it is you, tell me to come to you on the water." Peter gets out of the boat and starts walking towards Jesus. But because he took his eyes off Jesus and saw the wind, he was afraid and began to sink. But Jesus reached out and saved him and admonished him by saying, "You of little faith, why did you doubt?" His faith wavered when he realized what he was doing. We may not walk on water, but we do walk through tough situations and sometimes have to face challenges. If we focus on the waves of difficult circumstances around us, without looking to Jesus for help, we too may despair and sink. Have you had times in your life when it's been difficult or challenging and you have had to get out of the boat? At the end of 2018, our church finances were not in a healthy position as they are today. And as treasurer, I was looking for ways to save money, and also thinking of events to make money. I suggested to you, the church members, that when nobody is on holiday, we could look after ourselves instead of paying a minister, and thus saving £1,000 a year. Having made the suggestion, it meant that I also had to be prepared to I'll be taking. I'm able to stand here, but I'm not alone as I walk on the water. And now I'm asked you to give me this amount of decisions.
There is a response this morning. When I say, Lord, hear us, please respond with, Lord, graciously hear us. Let us pray, let us by prayer and intercession and with thanksgiving make our requests to God. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Gracious God, we pray for peace, justice and reconciliation throughout the world. We pray for the honouring of human rights and for the relief of the oppressed. We give thanks for all that is gracious in the lives of men, women and children. We pray especially for the people of Beirut in the Lebanon, that we hold them before you at this time. We pray for those who are searching through the rubble for survivors and for the bodies of the dead. We pray for those treating the injured in hospitals and those putting their lives back together. We pray for their broken government. Let them finally show leadership. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the renewal of the church in faith, love and service. We pray for Justin, our Archbishop, Rose and Trevor, our bishops, Mike, our dean, and Beverly, our rector, as she takes time off, and for her family. We pray for the life of this parish and community. Help our parish through this time, especially its leaders, as they seek to do what is right. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And our prayer for renewal. God of mission, who alone brings growth to your church, send your Holy Spirit to give vision to our planning, wisdom to our actions, and power to our witness. Help our church to grow in numbers, in spiritual commitment to you, and in service to our local community through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We give thanks for the gift of your word, the grace of your sacraments, and the fellowship of your people. We pray for this local community and for all people in their daily life and work. We pray for the young and the elderly, for families and all who are alone. We pray for those who have stopped shielding and for our whole community as we move into lockdown one. For those who are going on holiday, and for those returning from holiday. For those who have relatives in other parts of the UK and in the world in very different circumstances. May they be safe and healthy. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We give thanks for human skill and creativity, and all that reveals your loveliness. We thank you for the good weather that has allowed us and so many others to enjoy ourselves. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those who are in need, for the sick and the sorrowful. We think especially of Lucy, Doreen and Wayne. We pray for all who bring comfort, care and healing. We give thanks for human love and friendship and for all that enriches our daily lives. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And now in a moment of stillness, we remember those who are known to us who are suffering or in need. say their names out loud or remember them in the silence of our own hearts. Just commend ourselves and all for whom we pray to the mercy and protection of God. Amen.
We are not able to pass the flesh and around at the moment, but there will be a place on the welcome table as you come in, if you wish to make an offering. So we give thanks to God for all the offerings made this morning, and for all the money donated online or by standing order. Thanks be to God. And now for our St. John's family news. The church will be open on Wednesdays from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. for private prayer, if you wish to come in. But the steward is not any people.
We're joining by people from the UK and from Jersey.
There's people from the UK and from Jersey watching us online. So thank you for joining us and hope you enjoy the service. Next Sunday, 16th of August, we've got morning worship and Christ will be live again at 9:30, and the service will be led by Stuart Van Horn, our church treasurer. If anybody would like to make a donation to the ministry of mission of St. John's Church, if you're watching online, it's on the screen, and I think there's also a link on Facebook that you can donate money. So now we come to our second hymn, Be Thou My Vision. Please stand.
Thank you.
Let us say the blessing together. Where it is you, O Lord, please replace with us.